Greetings, Commanders, and welcome to Elite Week, your weekly source for all the news from in and around the Elite Dangerous Galaxy. I'm your host, Kai Zen. The goal of this show is to provide a clean description of anything and everything you might find of interest, along with easy links to the original sources. Since not all commanders are interested in the same things, you may find yourself clicking on many of these links and ignoring many others. That's great. My job isn't to tell you what to like, but rather to make you aware of all of it so you can decide for yourself. So let's get to it. The intro song was So Many Stars by Miguel Johnson from his album Explorers. So first off, we have on Friday, March 13th, Hutton Orbital Radio Podcast. This was recorded the previous night live on Twitch. They talked about Operation Hot Mess and the infrastructure failure that caused them some hassles with that project. They talked about the Elite Community Meet 2020, which has been postponed for now. It will be rescheduled when possible, but there is a virtual ECM that will be happening during the original dates. Obviously, since the government is requesting people to self-isolate in response to COVID-19, they're going to put on a sort of substitute ECM that everyone can tune into live from their houses safely and enjoy a community meetup. There will be further details on this, as well as the rescheduled date for the face-to-face ECM 2020 when it's safe. They also talked about the Formula One announcement. Frontier Development is doing a Formula One race management game. They discussed the Fuel Rats 70,000th rescue. Congratulations to the Fuel Rats. And special guest Commander Dog's Breath gave an overview of the Hutton Mugs trip to Antarctic, as well as having in as guest the creator of Gorgon's Loch, an RPG board game that is currently in its Kickstarter. Immediately following the program was Commander Wotherspoon's Powerful People, this week focusing on Pranav Antal, the tech utopian guru. As a side note, Commander Wotherspoon has now begun to release those Powerful People specials on his Galnet News Digest radio feed. So check it out. In other news, the community event, the Crazy Colonial Corrosive Cargo Caravan, is still ongoing. It began February 15th and will go till April Fool's Day. For full details on the event, check out their forum link provided. Commander Avassa over at AXI released the AXI debrief March 12th, 2020. They talk about no new incursions by the Thargoids. Operation Ida has a new app out that has links your Elite account and your Discord account to auto-update your delivery notices. They talk about Lave Radio giving them a great shout-out. And also, the defense reports are stopped for now until there is any further Tharg activity. Also, they talk about some interesting mechanics with regard to interceptors. If you run cool and follow certain parameters, you can bypass the caustic missiles and the shutdown fields. The anti-Xeno knowledge base has gotten an update from Commander Amgram. And Down to Earth Astronomy did an awesome interview with Commander Maligno about his 8 interceptor kill solo. The Science Hub for AXI has released their initial heat sink analysis and the weekly rank-up report. For this and all other AXI information, you can click on the link to the video provided, as well as the AXI Discord and Knowledge Base. Happy hunting, Commanders. Commander David Cooper put out 2 new videos, short ones, one on the Perseus Reach WP4 mass jump, and one on White Dwarf time-lapse. Both of them were interesting little exploration short videos. I thought they were cool, so I linked them. Check them out. Commander Sanderling released the Cortez Blooper Reel, a 2-minute long video that just shows you a little bit of the work that the Buckyballers and Elite Racers put in throughout the week, exploding over and over and over, trying to get it just right so they can release that video that makes them look godly to all of us. Hats off to you, Commander. HCS Voice Packs announced that they are having a massive sale on almost all of their voice packs. Also, there's a new immersive subscription pack add-on, Ad Astra, which will be up for early access and launching on Easter. So if you've been eyeing up some of those voice packs but didn't want to part with all the money, now's the time to get it cheap. The new community manager, Bruce Garrido, put out a call on the forums, send us your Hollow-Me's. They're gonna do some new secret project with them, so get yours in if you wanna be a part of it. Primetime Casual released his Guide to the Galaxy, Season 1, Episode 7, Bending Reality. It's a 4-minute long video at the location of Beta Hydrae. There's an EDSM link as well in the notes. It's close to Sol. It boasts a black hole and a binary with a neutron star. He has an amazing talk about the real-life science and history of these stellar phenomena. The Burr Pit put out the Witch Space News for Friday 13th. 6 minutes long, talks about the fuel rats crossing the 70,000 rescue line, the hot mess update, the Loose Screws podcast interview coming up with Stephen Benedetti, the images from Commander Placid, which there will be a link to his Instagram for those images as well as the Formula One race management deal announcements. Commander Matthias put out his Project Dynasty video, the Formadyne Rift. It's an 18-minute long video. It's the third, I believe, in the series, and it is amazing. For those people into the lore of the game, and specifically sort of the lore of the mystery of Project Dynasty, one of the greatest mysteries in the Elite Dangerous game, I highly recommend that you check out this as well as his other videos in the series. Great stuff. Big 07 to you, Commander. Which brings us to Saturday, March 14th, in which the Yamix released a new video, 10 Reasons Elite Dangerous is Better. It's a 13-minute long video. It's got great stuff. It's worth a watch. I want to just tell people who are worried that all of the Yamix's stuff is a little overly salty that this video is clever. It has some critiques, but it's low sodium mode. So check it out. I think you'll enjoy it. Hats off to you, the Yamix. Down to Earth Astronomy released Material Collecting Made Fun, Blunderbuss version 2.0, a 12-minute long video with his hilarious little Blunderbuss ship and how you can have some fun collecting materials. Might not be the fastest way, but it'll definitely be the way that makes you laugh the most. And speaking of laughing, check out Vindicator Jones' new video, Beluga Packhounds versus Passenger Comfort, 4 minutes long. It's a funny little video of him bounty hunting at compromised nav beacons in a beluga full of packhounds and passengers for the lulls. Sepulture Geist put out Lurid Hills and Oblong World, a 12-minute long video. One of his subscribers had listed a planet, a mysterious planet, at NGC 2546 Sector US-I-C10-5 Planet C1. And told him to check it out. So he flew out there. On the way, he passed an amazing little orange planet that he discovered with great little canyons and, I don't know, it was just crazy beautiful. He puttered about on that for a little while, and then he went to the mystery planet, and he found a planet with an 11,000 kilometer radius with 9 Earth gravities, but it's a weird little oblong planet. So, that's interesting. Following that, I've got a trio of treats from Commander Exorcist from the SPVFA. One is a video and two are photo compilations, all set to music, and all of it is amazingly beautiful. So check them out. Which takes us to Sunday, March 15th, 2020. Starting with Throwback Sunday, where I point out stuff that you may have missed from before, but is worth checking out. So let's get this party started with a pair of David Braben interviews. The first is from Alpha, and the second is from Lave Radio episode 100. The whole episode is listed there for you to check out. His second interview is broken up over 3 parts over the entirety of that episode, but it's worth checking out nonetheless. It's from 2016, and I don't know, the whole thing's pretty amazing. So go take a look at it and be inspired. Next up, we have TTS-4ED. This is a speech synthesis for NPC messages. So, you know, whenever you jump into a ring and you get that pilot talking about he's going to boil you up if you don't give him his cargo, it just puts that to an actual little voice so you get to hear it and kind of adds to immersion. It's pretty interesting. For those commanders that have ever gone out to a black hole and wondered why exactly it looks how it looks, Veritasium put out a video, How to Understand the Black Hole Image. It's a 10-minute long video in which he explains in detail the sort of lensing effect and how that works. So I found it fascinating. And we're going to follow that up with another real-life science video, To Scale the Solar System, 7 minutes long. This will blow your mind if you haven't seen anything like this before. He actually shows what it is like, the distances involved just in our solar system. So get ready to check out that little video and blow your mind. And bringing it back to the Elite Dangerous, we've got Mike Searle, who put out a video, The Biggest Star, VY Canis Majoris, a 7-minute long video of him visiting the largest star. And yeah, man, cool shit. And that'll wrap up our Throwback Sunday for this week, which brings us to the Rusty Dog Sunday Stream, revisiting the challenge of Nervy 3A. It's a 5.5-hour long stream. Like I've said before a million times, and I'll say a million more, throw on Rusty Dog for one of his 5-hour long streams on the second screen while you're out exploring or grinding Thargoids, and just relax, enjoy yourself with your best friend, Rusty Dog. Good stuff. This is followed by Scott Manley with his question and answer with the lead scientist of the asteroid mission, Osiris Rex. This is the mission to go out to the asteroid Bennu and get detailed information to send back to us to help us better understand the asteroid and asteroids in general. This was followed by the Tales from Tawanta Signals. There's a new episode out of that awesome blog about the goings-on in that system. The SPVFA put out 2020 Colors Competition Orange, a 6-minute long video of some of the most beautiful photography and camera work that you've seen done in the game, with the theme of orange and set to good music. So check it out. And finally for Monday, we have Insane Curiosity put out a video, The Skyhook, 1,000-kilometer cable to the stars. It's a 13-minute long video with an explanation in detail of the proposal of creating a huge cable that will help sort of assist in getting vehicles into orbit. It's sort of a variation of the old planetary elevator idea that Asimov had put forth, that Clark had talked about, that was in Star Trek, that has been in all kinds of interesting different forms of soft and then later hard sci-fi. They have this cool idea of using a massive cable with some pulleys and being able to sort of leverage the motion of the planet to assist in getting payloads into space. Seems super, super cool. Which brings us to Monday, the 16th of March. So we started off the day with the Loose Screws podcast interview series, the interview with Commander Plater. Guys, this interview was a joy. Plater is an awesome dude, and he got to share some great news, so check it out. Down to Earth Astronomy put out his Hello Dave, episode number 140, a 10-minute long video in which he talks about the clarification that Galnet and the CGs are on pause, not dead. Frontier Development's request of HoloMe screenshots for that project, the Formula One race announcement, and his honeymoon is being delayed because of COVID-19, so he will have more time to put out more content. Also, on his live stream schedule, he talked about that he's making a mining Python build, so stay tuned for that. The pilot put out the Imperial Clipper, a 9-minute video review of the Clipper. He used a ship called the Seven Veils, which should be a little hint for what came later. The video cut into a Salome story, complete with sort of jamming interference from the powers that be that don't want you to know. Later that day, Commander Plater put out a 2-hour stream called It's a Stream. Check it out. And Sanderling put out a jamming out to Tecoso while canyon racing like a maniac in an Eagle flight assist off video. It's 3 minutes long. It's pure joy. Go check it out. We also had an Elite Dangerous live stream, the Monday Let's Play, Mining Madness. It goes for about an hour. This is going to be the last stream for a little bit, guys, thanks to COVID-19. It was a great fireside chat. They talked about everything that's happening with COVID-19 and general stuff. They talked about the Hollow Me submissions request. No announcement on fleet carriers, etc., 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 but very, 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 very soon, TM. Commander Exegius took to Twitter to announce the Bucky Ball Racing Club is joining edtutorials.com. It's two great tastes in one. Sadly, Commander Vintayun from the Hutton Truckers took to Twitter to state that the ECM has been postponed for the time being. Further developments on that subsequently. The truckers are going to do the ECM on the original date, but it's going to be a virtual ECM so people can safely attend from their homes, check out streams. There's going to be events. There's going to be online role-playing games and all kinds of group activities for people who are isolated to do, which I know sounds like an oxymoron, but if there's anybody that can make it work, it's the Hutton Truckers. Much love to our trucking brothers for the mug. Also, there will be future information released as and when it is possible for when the actual real life face-to-face ECM can take place. So stay tuned. And of course, every Monday night, Sidewander Slaughter took place. This is the Level 11 Commander Exegius's group, player group. They sponsor a Sidewinder Slaughter event. It's every Monday at 8 p.m. EST. It's repeated on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. UTC for our European brethren. You can come out and basically enjoy risk-free combat PvP in a little sidey. There's fun little sort of mechanics to the event and how it works, but long story short, anyone can join and play with no experience whatsoever and have fun and learn how to do some PvP with no real cost to you. Which brings us into Tuesday, March 17th. Sagittarius I dropped a short documentary, Us or Them, Who is the Real Enemy? 12 minutes long on their YouTube page. Phenomenal documentary. Always check out everything that Sagittarius I puts out and for sure subscribe to their YouTube channel. Frontier Developments made a couple of announcements. First, on Twitter, they announced that they would be working from home and will maintain full service at this time. If there are any delays, they will be announced. Then on the forum, Stephen Benedetti, community manager, posted that we have decided to cancel all upcoming streams until further notice. This is obviously in response to the COVID situation and the fact that they're all working from home for now. Commander Exegius was a busy beaver. First, he put out an 8-minute long video called Thermal Vent Beam Laser Tested and Fully Explained. And immediately following that, he put out his tutorial Tuesday, Wing Deep Core Mining. So you get to see just what the mechanics are of deep core mining with a group. This was a 4-hour stream, so believe me, they get into every nook and cranny of the mechanics of that. Down to Earth Astronomy put out his Tuesday stream, Building Low Temperature Diamond Mining Python Live, a 3-hour long video that gets into all of those details. Which brings us to the main event of the day, which was Lave Radio Podcast, episode 284, The White Knight Mirror. Their guest stars today were Atris 5060 and Mac Winston. Of course, you had Suvereen, Shan, and Ben Moss Woodward, Commander Edelweiss, as the regular crew. This was some hilarious hijinks. So they went through a bizarro tunnel into an alternate universe of Lave Radio where fleet carriers have been out. There have been yearly updates. They've got atmospheric landings. They're hunting dinosaurs from their cobras. It's just, yeah. You got to go check that out. It's crazy time, and it's amazing. And hats off, big O7s to the guys at Lave Radio. Their show was, of course, immediately followed by Galnet News Digest Radio for March 18th, 3306, in which Commander Wotherspoon seems to have fallen through the same dimensional warp, because the Galnet News Radio was also from the Bizarro universe. So, yeah, check out both of those. They were amazing. There's nothing else I can say about it, but yeah. Which takes us to Wednesday, March 18th. Obsidian Ant put out the next video in his 3306 series. It's a 7-minute long video in which he discussed ECM was postponed, but virtual ECM will go off at the same time. Frontier Development working from home, Frontier Development requesting Hollow Me submissions, the Fuel Rat 70,000th rescue, and the amazingly realistic immersion mod, which there is a link for to the forum thread, which explains it in detail. That is some cool stuff that should definitely be checked out. As a side note, any that are interested in Stellaris coverage or content, you should definitely check out Obsidian Ant's page, because Ant's got a great sort of couple, three, four, multiple videos, one of which is like a 3-hour long stream. That's just really great stuff on that. Our very own JN Trax put out two separate streams this week that I'm clumping together here. First was Distant Screws, episode 3. It was a live stream with Alec Turner, 3 hours long. The second was Distant Screws, episode 4, from March 18th, a live stream that went for 4 hours, both of which are linked for you to check out. The B1M, that's Bravo 1 Mike, put out a video. This is how we build on Mars, 10 minutes long. This is a project that is going through the different ideas of how we can actually start to build up Mars for human use. Awesome stuff. And Down to Earth Astronomy put out a 9-minute long video predicting solar flares. So this is basically his master's thesis. This is what he got his degree in, and he explains it in great detail. It is an awesome 9-minute long video that should be watched by everyone. And lastly for Wednesday, Sagittarius Eye put out a breaking news bulletin. The Hull SEALs are tackling COVID-19. They are volunteering for a program called Folding at Home. It's a background program that they use to crowdsource computer analysis for research on COVID. Canon Research also volunteered for the same group, as are, I think, other people. As they find out about it, people are jumping on this. You should as well. It's good stuff. That brings us to Thursday, March 19th, our regular podcast recording day. For starters, we had Commander Burr with the Thursday Breakfast Club, and the stream was all about day 3 of being isolated in England and doing rep grind so that he could unlock an Isonor permit for a reason. And Commander Avassa put out the AXI debrief for Thursday, March 19th, 2020, 7-minute long video. They cover no new Tharg activity. A shout out for the Loose Screws podcast. The pilot with his Clipper video. Exegius Channel and the Sidewinder Slaughter. Guardian weapons, what's the meta? Guardian gauze cannons is the answer. And the rank ups for the week. Now, the Loose Crews podcast did not record an episode for Thursday the 19th. Some personal things came up. Ty will be releasing a short podcast announcement with some information. And we did do our interview Saturday morning with Frontier Development Community Manager Stephen Benedetti. So look forward to that being released Monday morning. And just as a final bonus before I wrap things up, so there is right now a limited time free giveaway on Steam. You can get Tomb Raider and Lara Croft and the Temple of Osiris. You can get both of those for free. This is a thing that Square Enix is doing, saying, while you're stuck isolated at home, enjoy some free games. So the links are in the notes below. Check them out. Download some free games and enjoy. This brings to a close the first episode of Elite Week for the week of March 19th. 3306. If you're listening to this on the podcast feed and you'd like the YouTube address for easy access to all of the links, you can go to tinyurl.com/EliteWeek3306, no spaces, all one word, and get access to it there. If you want to leave a message, you can post in the comments below, or you can send an email to EliteWeek3306@gmail.com. Elite Week is a part of the Loose Crews Podcast Network feed. If you're watching this on YouTube and want access to the network feed, you can go to anchor.fm/loosescrews, all one word, no spaces. The Loose Crews Podcast website page is loosescrewsed.com. And the Discord link for the Loose Crews Podcast Network is tinyurl.com/loosescrewspodcast, all one word. I hope you've enjoyed this show and that it's given you some cool links to go check out and dive deeper into the community. The video component for tonight's show has been provided by the incomparable Alec Turner. Go check him out at youtube.com/user/AlecTurner. I've also provided in the notes below a link to the Buckyball Race Club Discord, where you too can join the crazy Buckyball racers in all of their fanatic fun. And to play us out for our first episode, let's go with the amazing Commander Toko So and his Let's Jump Together.
Sleeping to the edges of the night. Oh.